बिस्मिल्लाहिर्रहमानिर्रहीम। अस्सलाम वालेकुम डियर स्टूडेंट्स, योर कोर्स इज़ द बायोकेमिस्ट्री ऑफ कार्बोहाइड्रेट्स एंड टुडे इज़ आवर टॉपिक ऑफ इंटरेस्ट इज़ द पॉलीसेक्राइड्स। व्हाट आर द पॉलीसेक्राइड्स? पॉलीसेक्राइड्स आर द पॉलीमर्स ऑफ ग्लूकोज और अदर कार्बोहाइड्रेट्स। दे आर द पॉलीमेरिक फॉर्म ऑफ द कार्बोहाइड्रेट्स। Polysaccharides are carbohydrates that are formed of more than 10 monosaccharidal units are called as the polysaccharides. They may contain hundreds or even thousands of monosaccharidal units. The predominant monosaccharides found in the polysaccharides are glucose. What is the classification? First of all, we have studies about the classification of the polysaccharides. Polysaccharides. The classification of the polysaccharides. First of all, we know about the classification of polysaccharides. According to their type, monosaccharide units type, they are divided into two parts: homopolysaccharides and heteropolysaccharides. According to their monosaccharidal units present in them, they are classified into two types, the homopolysaccharides and the heteropolysaccharides. Homopolysaccharides are those polysaccharides which are composed of same monosaccharidal units, and having the same monosaccharidal units are called as the homopolysaccharides. Only one type of monosaccharidal units are present in the homopolysaccharides. In case of heteropolysaccharides, the heteropolysaccharides are composed of more than one type of monosaccharidal units. They may be contain one or the other types of the monosaccharidal units present in the heteropolysaccharides. That's why they are called as the heteropolysaccharides. The examples of the homopolysaccharides are starch, glycogen, cellulose, inulin, and etc. The examples of heteropolysaccharides are the different types of glycosaminoglycans, proteoglycans, glycoproteins, agar, gum, arabic, and so on. This is the one type of the classification of polysaccharides. The other type of classification of polysaccharides, depending upon their, according to their physiological function. The second type of classification of the polysaccharides according to their physiological second type of classification of polysaccharides is according to their physiological functions. In case of this, they are also divided into two types. This is also divided into two types. The one type is the structure polysaccharides and the second type is the storage polysaccharides. Second one are the storage polysaccharides. In case of In case of the structure polysaccharides, they are the polysaccharides that enter in the structure of the cells. For example, the cellulose, which enters in the structure of the plant cell wall. They are comprises of the plant cell wall, mostly present in the plant cell wall. In case of storage polysaccharides, the polysaccharides that serve as the source of energy, so they are called as the storage molecules of the energy. For example, starch, which is the storage molecule of the plants, and glycogen, which is the storage molecule of the animal cells. We have studied their silent features one by one. First of all, we have studied the glycogen, which is the storage molecule of animal cells. Glycogen stored carbohydrate of animal cell storage molecule for the animal cells. It is a polymer of glucose, which is present in alpha 1-4 linkage in the straight chain. And in alpha 1-6 glycosidic linkage in branch chain. This is the polymer of glucose. The glucose units are attached with each other by the glycosidic linkage. In the straight chain, they are linked with the alpha 1-4 linkage, and in case of the branch chain, they are linked by the alpha 1-6 linkage. It is mostly found in the liver cells and the skeletal muscles. Glycogen is present in abundant. In liver cells and skeletal muscles. So these two organs are the storage organs of the glycogen in animal cells. Next polysaccharide is starch. That is a storage molecule of plant cell . It contains two sub molecules, that is amylose and amylopectin. It is also It is also the polymer of glucose. Polymer of glucose. And in it also the linkage is alpha 1 for linkage. In case of straight chain, and alpha 1 6 linkage in case of branch chain is present in it. Next polysaccharide is inulin. That is also the homopolysaccharide, and this inulin is found of fructose. This is the polymer of fructose, indicator of diabetic patients' diet. Next one is the cellulose. That is also the homopolysaccharide, and this homopolysaccharide is the polymer of glucose. But in this case, the glucose molecules are attached by the beta 1,4 linkage, in this the glucose molecules are attached with each other by the beta 1,4 glycosidic linkage. It is mostly found in the cell walls of the plants, and cellulose is extremely resistant to hydrolysis by the digestive tract enzymes, so it can stimulate peristaltic movement and prevent constipation, because the enzyme for the digestion of the cellulose is lack in case of the animal cells and in case of the humans as well. Next are the heteropolysaccharides, in which the first one is the glycosaminoglycans, which are also called as the mucopolysaccharides. These are also called as the mucopolysaccharides. They are heteropolysaccharides of different discoidal units, generally composed of a repeating discoidal units. The heteropolysaccharides linear are a long linear unbranched heteropolysaccharides. They are the long linear unbranched heteropolysaccharides. The discoidal units is usually formed of sugar acid and the amino sugar. Mostly in them the present is amino sugars or the sugar acids. Examples of glycosaminoglycans are heparin. First one is heparin. Second one is हाइलुरोनिक एसिड, थर्ड टाइप इज कॉन्ड्राइटिन, सल्फेट, फोर्थ वन इज क्रिएटिन सल्फेट, these are the four different types of the glycosaminoglycans, mucopolysaccharides, heparin, hyaluronic acid, chondroitin sulfate and the keratin sulfate. They usually contains the glucosaminoglycans. They usually contain the glucosamines, galactosamines, glucuronic acid. They usually contains the different glucuronic acid, galactosamines, glucosamines. Glucosamines, galactosamines, glucuronic acids, N-acetyl glucosamines. N-acetyl galactosamines and different molecules of sulfate. Sulfates. After this, glycosaminoglycans, the next one, heteropolysaccharides are proteoglycans, which contains the mucopolysaccharides. Different types of mucopolysaccharides combined with different proteins covalently give rise to the proteoglycans. If the different types of mucopolysaccharides are attached covalently, covalently with the proteins molecules, then they are forming the proteoglycans. Proteoglycans are the also the examples of the heteropolysaccharides. Next one are the glycoproteins. Glycoproteins are proteins which covalently bounded with different oligosaccharides units. Different types of oligosaccharidal units, when combined with the protein molecules, they give rise to the glycoproteins. Glycoproteins are also the examples of the heteropolysaccharides. Glycoproteins, membrane bounded glycoproteins, are having the very important roles in the cell surface recognition by the other cells and the hormones. Cell surface antigenicity, such as the blood group antigens, can bind. Blood group antigens can also be bound with the different types of the glycoproteins. Structure of the extracellular matrix and the mucin acting as the protective biological lubricants is the very different types of the enzymes and many of the hormones, antigens, blood groups. They are the examples of the glycoproteins. Many type of the antibodies, which are also the glycoproteins, they are synthesized for the binding of the antigen molecules with them. So glycoproteins have a very vast functional properties in different types of molecules. The next one is the glycolipids. Glycolipids are the combination of the carbohydrate moiety with the lipid molecule. It is also covalently bonded with the different types of lipid molecules. Glycolipids are very important in case of the body, because they are glycerophospholipid. Many type of the glycerophospholipids are of glycolipid types, and they are very important they have the very important role in the cell membranes, because they are present within the lipid bilayer. So these glycolipids and the glycoproteins are very important for the recognition of different types of the foreign particles, which can be bind with them, and they are to be into the cell, or they can be differentiated from the cell wall, from the cell membrane. So they are very important heteropolysaccharides. Then what are the benefits of the different types of polysaccharides? Polysaccharides are very important because they have a wide variety of arrangements. They are present in the diet. Maybe they are very important. They have the very important uses. They are the high rich sources of energy production. Polysaccharides are very important sources of energy production, because they are the high molecules. They are the higher molecules. They contains the 100 to 1000 glycosidic units and monosaccharidal units attached with each other. And they, if only one molecule of glucose provides a huge amount of energy, when you have a polysaccharidal units and you have to break down them by the hydrolysis into their monosaccharidal units, they are a rich source of energy productions. So they are very important for the body for the production of different type of energy. And also the body can store the energy in the form of the polysaccharides, like the glycogen, and this plant cells also store the energy in the form of the polysaccharides like the starch molecule. So they are the energy production and also the storage molecules of the cells, because cells can be stored different types of polysaccharides within their cells for the rest of the use of the energy. When the energy is required, then these storage molecules are broken down into their monosaccharidal units, and they can be used for the production of different types of energy production in different organs. Thirdly, they are very important structure, molecules, because they provide the structural strength to the cells. They are like that of the cellulose. Cellulose is a very important part of the cell wall, so they give rise to the cell strength and the structural strength of the cells. Also, different types of polysaccharides like chitin and agar are present in the plant cells, which give them the structure of that molecules to be stronger and more hard, and did not be easily be broken down by the different types of medicine. They contains a high amount of fiber contents like that of cellulose. Cellulose is a very much high in the fiber content. So cellulose, by using them in the diet, they provide the intestinal motility, and the intestine of small intestine have the great motility with the when the fibrous content is more in diet. So they are to be very much important for the energy, not only for the energy production, but also they are very important for the digestive system. Very important for the digestive system to be in their healthy manners. So we have must be included in our diet the different types of fibrous materials, which is rich in the cellulose, and the cellulose is a high amount of fibrous content because they are not to be digested by the intestinal enzymes. The enzyme for the digestion of the cellulose is not present in the animal body, so they can be remain undigested, but it provides the fibrous content to the body and it gives the motility of intestinal motility to be at high rate. So the digestive system more appropriately works by in the presence of the cellulose or the fibrous contents in the diet. Then the different types of the glycoproteins are very important for the identification of different types of antigens present within the cell. So they are the markers for the identification of different types of antigens present on the cell. So they are the recognition factors. They can easily be bind with the different types of antigens, and these glycoproteins are very important for the removal of the antigens from the cells, and also they provide the strength to the cell wall and the cell membrane, and the toxic material can't be going into the cell by passing through these glycoproteins barrier. So they are very important immunoglobulins, which are very important for the different types of production of the antibodies and having the recognition factors. Similarly, different types of mucopolysaccharides are very important for the production of the molecules, which give the different types of the strength to the cells, and we will discuss in other lecture about the mucopolysaccharides, which have the different beneficial functions for the cell, plant cell and the animal cells. Then the glycolipids are high, they are present in high amounts glycolipids are also present in very high amounts into the cell membrane, and it provides the ion channels, ion immunity, the molecules which are the lipid soluble, and they can't be goes into the cell membrane. They not be passed out through the cell membrane. The glycolipids are used for them to be bind by the lipid bilayer, and these can be easily be passed out through the membranes. So glycolipids are also very important part of the polysaccharides. These all are about the different types of polysaccharides which we later on discussed in detail the R types of the polysaccharides and their importance one by one in the upcoming lectures. This is the general introduction about the polysaccharides and the classification of different types of polysaccharides. Hope you have understand about the classification and the types of the polysaccharides. If you have any questions regarding this lecture about the polysaccharides, you can approach me on my WhatsApp group, or you can write me in the comment section of the YouTube channel, or you can write me an email for your questions. Thank you so very much, students. Allah Hafiz.